in my eyes. Oh. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel and training for Marathon in Mountains episode 6. Not really sure to start today's video off. We were meant to be centering this episode on Wednesday's epic hill session. However, Saturday, you may remember me saying I had a slight niggle in my knee. Well, it escalated as the day went on, to the point where even walking downstairs was painful and just generally feeling it all day. I've given it lots of TLC, from yoga to ice baths, deep heat, the lot, but we'll discuss that in more detail later on. The point is, tonight is an easy session. We need to see how the knee responds. Tomorrow is a moderate effort. If I feel anything during that moderate effort, I'm going to have to ease off and we're going to have to cancel Wednesday. This run also takes my Speed Goat 4 in wide fit over the 100 mile mark. So we're going to discuss my thoughts at 100 miles, how I think it's doing durability wise, whether I still like the shoe, what I'm using it for, all that good stuff. Let's begin with how the Speed Goat 4 has worn over the last 100 miles. We'll begin from top to bottom. So, the upper, spot on. Not got a mark on it, no holes, no cracks appearing. And based on some of the things I'd heard off other users, I was quite surprised by this. I thought I'd start seeing a few creases appear, but that hasn't been the case, thankfully. Going down to the midsole, I haven't noticed anywhere on that either. It's still just as bouncy as it was the day I took it out of the box, and it was a wear it out the box type shoe, so very impressed with that. Rounding it off with the outsole, the Vibram's held up pretty well. I am seeing a bit of wear on the outside, I'll try and get you some shots of that. But other than that, it's doing very well indeed. It's still sticky, and it's still about as deep lugs as what I had from day one. We'll just take a quick pause, guys, while I chat to you about the knee. So this could be a number of things. I pronate, which means I roll my knees in. This puts pressure on the outside of my knee, so I could have well damaged the meniscus or something inside that keyhole. Equally, it could be IT band related, where it gets really tight from the glutes all the way down the outside of your leg to the knee joint. That can pull on things inside the knee and cause problems in itself. And as I said, yesterday's treatment worked a treat. I feel much better today, but we don't know how tonight's run is going to aggravate things and tomorrow's moderate effort should I get through it. So the next time you see me, fingers crossed, we'll be at Hutton the Hole on the moors and I'll have some positive news for you. Hey guys, as you've probably guessed, we are in Hutton the Hole, so gonna be doing that hill session tonight. The knee still isn't quite right. Monday's easy session flared it up a little bit. Yesterday's moderate effort again flared it up. Towards the end of the run, it was starting to hurt a bit, and then all of a sudden just seemed to disappear. Because of that, I think it is more IT band related, which is more of an inflammation, irritation injury. So we're gonna give it a go, play it by ear, and if I feel any really bad pains, we're gonna have to turn around and come back to the car. Tonight's session is 3 hill reps in total. The first is 5 minutes with some squat thrusts at the end, and then the next two are 8 minutes apiece. Halfway through the 8 minute rep, we're gonna do 40 squat thrusts, and then at the top, another 20. This is to mimic what will happen in the Yorkshire Three Peaks, where I'll be running fast, then have to go on a steep climb, and then be able to push off the top again. As for shoe choice, we're going for the Adidas Terrex Speed Ultra. Reason being, they're the best I've got for stability, and if this is an IT band related issue I've got in my knee, we need as much stability as we can and less cushioning. Okay, we better get this thing underway, so let's hit the trail. Yeah. right, guys, the reps are going to start from here, going up that track behind us for 5 minutes the first one, 8 minutes the next two. The legs are a little bit tired from last night's moderate effort. That was sub 8 minute miles for around 8 miles. That's the whole point of the session, to realize what it's like to do this climbing on heavier legs. Going to get rid of my pack, do a couple of really quick stride outs, and then we'll get on with it. Okay, rep one and go. Almost there. Okay, back down to the bottom, and then we've got the 8 minute reps. Okay, we go again for rep number two, and go. Nearly there. Oh God. Okay, last one, let's make this one count. Go. Sweat in my eyes. Oh. There we go. That was a great session, guys. Lots of mileage on the North York Moors, purposeful practice for the Yorkshire Three Peaks. I'll pull all the stats up on screen. And of course, we're gonna be extending on that as time goes on and upping those reps to be longer. As for the knee, it seemed to handle it quite well. I was feeling it every now and again, but not too severe. It had a nice rest on Thursday, and then we had a massage on Friday. The masseuse did say she found a lot of tension in my back and upper body, so it all seems to be coming from higher up. Bit of instability maybe in the hips and around. A few of my weak points are probably all coming together, and it's coming out in my knees. It's now Saturday. I've just finished a 7 mile run around home. We did 4 miles at a tempo effort, just getting that faster pace into my legs with a few easier efforts. So all in all, not a bad week's worth of training. We're pushing the 40 mile mark again. Next week is a biggie because we've got the recce of the Yorkshire Three Peaks on Wednesday, a really hard hill session on Saturday, and the usual training around that. I wanted to finish the episode off talking about the Speedgoat 4 Wide Fit again. I mentioned to you about the outsole. This is precisely what I'm talking about, just here. I tend to strike towards the edge of the shoes, and that has worn out quite quickly. Other than that though, as you can tell, it's actually held up quite well on the grip side of things. As for use, I do still find them a little bit too squishy. They worked well in the 48 mile Hardwells 40, but yeah, just a little bit too unstable for my liking. And if you're on technical terrain, I don't think I'd be reaching for them. I'm actually finding I'm reaching more for the Ultra Glide at the moment. I'd love to use the Scarpa more, but I think that's what's escalated my knee to the level it's at now with the instability because of the sizing issues. Brilliant shoe, but for me, just not quite the right fit. And of course, we can't finish any episode about talking about my book of the week. You've probably all read this one, to be fair, but it's Born to Run. One of the first ultra running books I ever read. So amazingly inspirational. It is outside the box. This guy travels over to Mexico, finds a tribe, the Tarahumara, who are essentially the best ultra runners, natural ultra runners in the world. And he ends up pitting them against some of the best ultra runners from America. And yeah, I won't spoil any surprises for you, but it's such an inspirational read. Really interesting, goes into a great amount of detail on why barefoot running is much better for you than the high cushion shoes that I've been wearing recently. But yeah, if you haven't read this yet, highly recommend it. I think anyone who's into ultra running and really serious about it probably gained some inspiration from this. Okay guys, I'm gonna sign off at that. I have no idea what I'll be bringing you next week because it's gonna be a bit of a busy one. But take care, and I'll see you with the next episode.